morning and welcome to another Sunday group session. And what, you must be thinking, am I wearing today? So let me give you today's Bible reading, and that might give you a bit of a clue as to why I'm dressed like I am. So we're in the book of Ephesians in the New Testament, from verse 10 to verse 18. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armour of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armour of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled round your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. So here is my armour, including my footwear. And what I believe it sort of tells us in that reading is to sort of is protecting ourselves. So I don't know if you know this from maybe history at school, but the armour was based on the Roman soldiers' armour, because back in that day, when the Roman Empire was at its large, then they had a really good protective armour. And Paul's letter to the Ephesians that describes that armour, that's what he was talking about. And each piece of the armour protects us in a different way. And that's why God is saying to us, put on your armour. And then, once the armour's on, it's not telling us to go out and fight or run away and hide. It's just telling us to stand. And I believe that is because God will then protect us. That we've got the armour on. We're being looked after. We're not being called to go out and fight a battle, because God does it on our behalf. So, here's this week's challenge. I think you've got a pretty good idea of what I'm going to ask you to do. So, you can either, with the help of your parents or grandparents, look around your house and find some objects in the kitchen or wherever else to create your own armour and dress up in your own armour. Or you can draw us a picture of somebody in armour, and then take a picture of it, send it to me, and then I will share it again on the WhatsApp group. So let's finish with a prayer. Father God, thank you that we can read your word and learn about you. And thank you that you show us how we can sort of look after ourselves and be protected by you, by putting on this armour. It's not a physical armour that we're putting on, but it's kind of an imaginary armour that we put on around us, that we can continually pray to you, be shielded by you, be protected by you. And Lord, I pray that that you can remind us each day to put this armour on, that in our minds that we can kind of read through what each bit of the armour is about, or we can read the Bible reading to remind us, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that as we go about our week, that you will look after us and our families. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay. See you. See you in a week.